Welcome to the new episode of Statistical Computing. In this session, I am going to discuss how to find quartiles, deciles, and percentiles in case of simple series. So the question is, find quartiles B7, P30 of the following observation, and the observations are this. So first of all, I will arrange this observation into the ascending order. The procedure of to find quartiles, deciles, and percentile is similar to the median, right? So first of all, we will arrange into the ascending order, right? So the ascending order, the smallest value is 12, 19, 21, 24, 26, 29, 33, 35, and 36. Okay. So after arranging this into the ascending order, right, you have to find Q1, Q2, Q3, D7, and P30. Total 5 values we have to find, right? So first of all, I'm going to count the number of observations. So my n is 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 and 9. It's an odd number, so I'll put the formula for the Q1. So Q1 is n plus 1 divided by 4th value of the observation, which is 10 divided by 4, and it's 2.5th value of the observation, right? So 2.5, which is in between second and the third observation, so it is within 19 and 21. So let's see, let's open this value. Let's say this is the second observation plus 0.5 into third observation minus second observation. So according to this, my second observation is 19 plus 0.5, third is 21 minus 19. So 19 plus 0.5, so the difference is 2. So 2 into 0.5 is 1, right? So this is 20. Your Q1 is 20, right? So now we'll find Q2. So for Q2, the value is 1 divided by 4. See, in the case of Q1, here also we have I, but here the I is 1, right? So if you multiply any value with 1, which is again similar to that value, right? So here I will be 2, right? So now in this case, this is n plus 1 by 4, right? So we have already found that is 9 plus 1. Right, that which is 10, 10 by 4 is 2.5. It's like this, 9 plus 1 by 4. So it's 2 into 10 by 4. It's 2 into 2.5. Right? So 2 into 2.5 is 5th observation. So our 5th observation is 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5, which is 26. So your Q2 is 26th, right? Now we will find Q3 here, I into n plus 1 by 4, right? So I is 3 and n is 9 plus 1 by 4. So this is 3 into 2.5, which is 7.5th observation. Now, according to the 7.5th observation, it is 7th observation plus 0.5 into 8th observation, into 8th observation minus 7th. So, 7th observation, if we observe 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and this is 8, right? So, 7th observation is 33 plus 0.5. into 35 minus 33, right? So 33 plus 0.5 into 2, again it is 33 plus 1. So your Q3 will be 34, right? Similarly, we will find D7 and P30. So, in case of D7, I into n plus 1, it's a decile. So, instead of quartile, we have, deciles here, right? So, for D, so the value is 10 for deciles. So, instead of 4, we will divide this by 4, right? So again here your I will be 7 and this is 9 plus 1 by 10. So 7 into, sorry, it's a 10 by 10 which is 1. So your 7th value, 7th observation is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7, which is 33. So your D7 is 33. And we will find here P30. So in case of percentiles, right, I into n plus 1. It's a percentile, so the value is here 100, right? So I is 30 and 9 plus 1 divide by 100. So 30 into 10 divide by 100 0.10, so which is 3rd observation. So the 3rd observation is 1, 2 and 3. So your P30 is 21, right? So if you observe the value, right, so the whole series, right, let's say the whole series is I'll write again, which is 12, 19, 21, 24, 26, 29, 33, 35 and 36. So the whole series in case of quartile, it divides in 4 equal part, right? So you will get 3 point, which is Q1, Q2 and Q3, right? So in case of that, the Q1 is here, right? Q2 is 26, which is this, and Q3 is 34, right? Okay. So in case of deciles, right, the whole series is divided into 10 equal parts, right? This is quartiles, so 4 parts for quartiles, 10 parts for deciles. So for this, your D7 is here, right? So this will stated here in the series, right? So the same series is divided in 10 equal parts. If you find D1, D2, D3, right? So you will get the point accordingly, right? And for percentile, it divides the whole series into 100 equal parts, right? So your P30 is 21, right? So the again whole series for percentile, the whole series is divided into 100 equal parts, and you will get total 99 percentiles. So P1 up to P99, right? So from this many value of the percentiles, we have found here P30. Similarly, from 9 points of deciles, we have found here D7, and we have found all the quartiles Q1, Q2 and Q3, right? Easy. Okay, thank you for watching my video. We'll meet soon in the next session.